Okay, Mark, Heather, Sam, each of these dishes are way off. 60 minutes to come up with something with ingredients that you know on a daily basis. Right now, we're concerned. These do not show us potential, skill, technique. You can't be happy with them, can you?
No.
Mark, let's talk. The pancake, it has problems. It's undercooked. Seeing raw apple and raw banana just stuck on the plate is like the finesse isn't there. The hash brown, it almost looks like a piece of meat. I know what you can do. I watched you make the most beautiful, delicious ravioli that won you that apron, and it feels like a completely different home cook made this dish.
I feel like it was the fourth quarter with 2 minutes left, and I ran onto the field without my helmet or my jock strap. And I left both my proteins on my table.
It's underwhelming and disappointing, to say the least.
Heather, I'm baffled. Describe to me what happened here.
I tried to work with all the flavors that my mother cooked with from Peru, with a lot of the herbs and a lot of the spices. It didn't turn out the way that I wanted.
I just think, for me, it came down to the fundamentals. You cooked it meat side down instead of skin side down. It's dry as a bone. You have no sauce. You didn't peel the carrots, so they're completely muddy and dirty. You know, you mentioned your mom and you mentioned Peru. And like when you say that with such conviction, then you serve me that. It's a complete travesty to all the great Peruvian cooks that I call friends and colleagues.
Sammy, you look pissed.
I don't like the way my dish looks.
That doesn't look anywhere near like a meatloaf. Just bland, horrible. But the one issue I have with you is you need to pay attention. A meatloaf needs time to cook, right? That's an insipid burger. But above all that, the sauce was disgusting. You're blowtorching a can of tomatoes. Young man, you got to stop getting carried away with all the frills. I don't give a rat's ass about the chicken skin on top of mashed potatoes. What was the hero tonight?
It was supposed to be the meatloaf.
Well, it wasn't. And you got to start taking this seriously. Got me?
Yes, Chef.
Rush the chimichurri onto the chicken as you're cooking it.
Will do.
Yeah?
I'm trying.
You know what you could do, Heather? Just do what I do and ignore them.
Somehow I don't think that's the best strategy, Mark.
Young man, is this a joke for you?
No.
Is this just a big show-off for your mates?
No.
No, we'll take it serious or take your apron off.
Seriously.
Take it serious or take your apron off. What is going on here?
What is Mark doing? This is embarrassing.
Are you serious? Mark does not care about this competition whatsoever. Mark thinks the world stops for him. Not today, baby. Mm-mm.
I am a debt collector and I deal with really stressful situations, but being in this pressure test was really hard for me today. I lost my cool during the cook, but I feel like it doesn't reflect on my play. I feel like I pulled it together and elevated in the best way that I could.
Young lady, first of all, previous challenge, you captained your blue team to that miserable loss. Is this redemption? Have you come back strong?
Yes, Chef.
Right, let's get in there, shall we? It's undercooked. All we need is a mud bath, and that thing can go back in the field.
You're right.
The pork is undercooked. The actual cactus seasoning, actually nailed. Sauce, you got that balance between the heat, the acidity. Here's what frustrates me about you. You get a little knockback, and you sort of disintegrate. And I think that you may have one foot out the door. Chin up. Sam.
Yes, Chef.
Okay. Visually, just look left and look right, and then come back to your liquid scrambled egg.
Yes.
Joe, it's like a grilled cheese from here. What do I need, a straw? So what is it with you and the timing?
I have a hard time focusing, and the time is hard for me.
We're talking about scrambled eggs.
I'm aware.
Sam, what would you give yourself in class out of 10?
I don't know, about a 5.
Five. Send us.
What did you learn from that first cook?
My eggs were overcooked. I also was under seasoned, so I added salt. I also put some pepper in there as well to get a little kick.
It's a lot of pepper.
I was a little heavy-handed with the pepper, probably.
Let's just take a look at this color-wise.
Wow, you see the color is dark and gray.
I may have put a little too much pepper to make it that brown color.
And they're almost gray from black pepper, Heather.
Sam, come forward.
I've been in the bottom a lot, but I'm confident with my dish. It's no more flunking. I'm ready to get that A paper. That's what I'm here to show the judges today.
Sam, how do you feel it went for you there?
I made some mistakes, but I got everything there, and frankly, it's one of the prettier plates I've presented for you guys.
Delan, why did you choose to sauce the top part of the chop?
I was trying to keep the sauce off the crust, most importantly.
What is that?
I think that's some of the sauce that congealed.
I think maybe you over-reduced it, which is a little bit disappointing. I think the fact that you sauced the top of the lamb also shows a lot of oversight. Look at that. That right there is rare. Black and blue, right? I mean, this thing still has fur on it. I mean, here's the deal. Had this lamb been cooked a little bit better, I can overlook some of the other glaring issues, which is that crust. Look at that. Does that look like your crust, Gordon? I don't think so. That's too much breadcrumb, right?
Yeah.
Well, the sauce has a lot of flavor.
Thank you.
That's the only thing I can gravitate towards that gives me some relief from the undercooking of the lamb. There are some fundamental mistakes that are very hard to overlook.
Sam, I don't mind the rare, medium rare, pink, beautiful, but blue, there's no excuse for. Now, the lamb, it's so rare that even the fat hasn't even rendered down. Also, the actual crumb mixture is so bland and anemic looking, it looks unappetizing. So, blue lamb is an insult to the cut. Ah, I won't even swallow that. I can't do that to my palate. Let me ask you this. Are you happy with it?
I might eat it.
No. Seriously, eat blue lamb?
Yeah, I would.
For you to turn around and openly admit that you'd eat that, that tells me a lot about you, Sam.
I'm disappointed. I really wanted to impress the judges, and I failed at that today. But I know that my flavors are there, and I hope it's enough to keep me safe.
All right, Nico. What's going on here?
We have a marinated grilled hanger steak.
Nico, I'm confused. What is this? I don't understand what's going on. It looks a little bit like a sausage patty with hash browns. This makes me feel like it's food for like a little dollhouse.
I don't think so. I feel like my presentation is hands down the best, and my flavors mend well together.
Maybe I'm not really understanding the inspiration. Tell me what you mean.
We have a marinated grilled hanger steak with morels sauteed in brown butter, a stuffed tomato, and a potato cake. I felt that the plating was nice this way.
Okay. Temperature-wise, what were you going for?
I was hoping for a medium rare.
All right, let's see what we got. Ooh, it's undercooked. Look at that. What happened there?
I feel it's not deep red.
But I got a big old bloodline coming in there. You need more time searing this, and you didn't give it enough time to rest. You know, Nico, you didn't nail any element on the plate. Presentation is disappointing. I'm sorry. All right, Brian. I'm looking for 6 beautiful cannoli. Let's see what we got. How's your math?
I failed to put 6 in the box, Chef.
They look terrible.
All right, what's in the box?
Today we have a peanut butter and jelly theme. The first one is
peanut butter and ricotta filled cannoli.
And then the other one is a raspberry coulis.
I'd rather have 4 brilliant cannolis than 6 sloppy cannolis, but your problem is I don't know that any of these cannolis look elegant. I mean, this one just looks broken.
I did spend much too much time on the filling. I knew that I was gonna run out of time, and so I just kind of cut my losses.
The filling is definitely too loose, which is why it's kind of starting to look a little bit like, with all due respect, it looks a little throw-up-y. And this one?
The peanut butter.
Better ratio of filling to cannoli shell. You know, there's nothing wrong with that peanut butter filling, except it just doesn't belong in a cannoli. Not impressive.
Yes, chef.
All right, so let's see.
God.
Is this the end of your time here, Chef?
I don't think so.
Let's talk about the obvious.
There's five, and the challenge was for six.
Did you eat one? So you have two flavors. What are they?
A cannoli that is stuffed with balsamic, a mascarpone, and then it has a blood orange chocolate ganache.
What is this?
That is a candied caramel with a candied bacon in there, and then it has a bourbon-infused filling.
That's very savory. It tastes like bacon that's been left on the griddle, and then you just chopped that up and then stuffed it into a cannoli. And I'm looking down this row of cannolis, and I'm just thinking, Adam, he's in trouble. Brian, I mean, he has the same problem with math. I think you're in that same boat right now.
Clearly, that was a tough challenge. I didn't get a cupcake the way that I wanted a cupcake. So, I went a little abstract. It may not be the prettiest dessert, but coconut was a star. Coconut is shining in my dish.
Kate, when you gave Jeff the pink basket, did you honestly believe it would be this bad?
No, Chef. He tried to bake with coconut flour, and coconut flour just absorbs and has no gluten. It's just, it looks like it's crumbled and put back together.
Describe the dish, please, Jeff.
So what I have here for you, Chef, is a deconstructed coconut cupcake with a toasted and candied spiced almond raspberry crumble. I decided to have the deconstructed cupcake route.
I'm sick to death of the word deconstructed because it's just a word to cover up the actual mess. I see what you've done in this competition. I've seen how determined you are. And then I taste this. It's just, I've got two different Jeffs tonight.
Yes, you do.
The mix is cooked, but it tastes dreadful. And the garnish is just confusing. The potential was there, but that is your worst performance. Come here. Are you done?
Am I done? I got a lot more to give, and my journey is not gonna be over because of this. I'm gonna come back even stronger with a better performance and a better dish.
My problem is, Jeff, I don't think you will have another chance. Adam, tell me about the dish.
The dish is Japanese fried chicken with a miso confused.
Deep fried chicken, elevated, miso ready to go home. Seriously, deep fried Japanese chicken.
Those aren't good faces.
Did the chicken take off?
No, chef.
Describe the morsel.
It's a chicken roulade with Swiss chard.
A chicken roulade? Where is that? Underneath? Because I feel like I've just been planted in my daughter's doll's house. A chicken roulade, it's not. Where's the roulade and where's the chicken? A chicken roulade, it's not. Where's the roulade and where's the chicken? Did you see Aaron's roulade?
Yes, chef.
That's what you call a roulade. Describe the dish, Gabriel.
It's a stuffed chicken thigh with some greens, potatoes, gratin, and a red wine sauce.
A red wine? What is the red wine?
It broke completely. It was very, very acidic, and we tried to fix it.
So, chicken roulade. Holy s***. Who cooked this little dollop of potato?
I did, Chef.
I mean, that's the only visual impact on the plate. That looks beautiful. How long did you cook them for?
Cooked them in the oven for about 35 minutes.
Wow. Potatoes are delicious. Roulade's a disaster. Sauce is dreadful. Crispy skin is just bizarre. But the potatoes are to die for, so I'm pissed off. You didn't listen to each other. You weren't playing to your strengths. I think, equally, on your own, both of you could have done a better job.
I agree. I am totally embarrassed. This is the worst thing that I have ever presented. In my mind, I already have a black apron on and preparing for my third head-to-head challenge.
This was a hard challenge. I thought being put in teams of two was going to be simple. It's only two voices to put forward on a plate. But man, it really proved challenging to marry Adam's Japanese inspiration with what I know.
What did you make for us tonight?
We made a Japanese fried chicken with miso, a potato puree, and a sake slaw.
Did you guys taste all the elements together?
Not all of them together.
Wrong answer.
So you're going to combine something that you haven't tasted together yet. How'd you make it this far? I can see that you're clearly trying to raise the bar in terms of plating, because yes. You thought about the color of the plate.
Absolutely.
You thought about how you were going to lay the food out. But it's clear that you didn't taste the elements of the dish together, because really the only thing you can taste is this sort of miso glue that is the puree on the plate. The chicken is just kind of nothing for me. And to be honest, I'm thinking, okay, so in 60 minutes, Adam made fried chicken nuggets. And in 60 minutes, Caitlin made a potato puree, fried some Brussels sprouts, and made slaw. That's embarrassing.
Yeah. I think we're okay.
Wow. This, Japanese, it's a chicken nugget. Come on. I'm more Japanese than this. And then the pomegranates, it's like you guys couldn't stop yourselves. I mean, I swear to God, I see what you've both done in this competition, and you've had moments of brilliance, but tonight, you just accept your and look at the result. A soggy, disgusting nugget sat on a bed of unwanted slaw over a gummy puree that I'd give my granddad to paste his house, put new wallpaper, not to eat. Disgusting. Adam, chicken looks beautiful. How long did you poach it for?
17 minutes, about.
You tell me. What's wrong with that?
It's raw in the middle, Chef.
Oh, Adam. Damn, 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 damn. Oh, dear. Let's go to the end here. How ironic for me to see you perform the best you've ever cooked in this competition, nail a dish, and then we get into the chicken and it's under. The dish is absolutely incredible. Croquettes are light, fluffy, crisp on the outside. The actual flavors are mind-blowing. But what pains me, you're 90 seconds short of having that chicken cooked to perfection. I know how talented you are, you just proved that, but that's a brilliant effort, young man. Remember that.
It's okay, Adam, you still did a great job.
Take a deep breath, Adam. Take a deep breath.
Oh, it's okay, Adam.
I took a leading role with this entire tag team challenge because Caitlin didn't bring a lot to the table. We might not have gotten the small details, but at least we got everything on the plate.
Jeff, Caitlin, you had the three best pair of eyes on both of you tonight, and we were frustrated the fact that Jeff was overbearing. And you, Caitlin, you weren't in this game tonight, and it's controlled all by Jeff.
I felt like Jeff was talking me through things that were four or five steps down the road, and that just made it harder for me to focus on the task at hand.
How would you rate this platter out of 10?
3 or a 4.
I beg to differ. I would have actually gone a little bit higher. I would have gone a 7 because everything is there.
Because everything's there, it doesn't mean that this is on a 7. Come on, guys. I am not going to accept that.
Okay.
Nowhere near it. Now, let's go to the churros. 7 is not. Let's get that right. Who put them in the fryer?
I did, Chef.
If I stick all 4 together, I may get 1 decent churro. Who shredded the lamb?
I did, Chef.
It's like the lowest form of dog food. It's just chunks.
I was working as fast as I can to shred it with 2 forks and...
Yeah, shocking. Who cooked the chicken?
I did.
And how long was that cooked for?
5 minutes into the fryer.
My grand's flip-flops had more texture. Savisha, who did that?
I did.
The actual flavor is delicious.
Thank you.
Unfortunately, the tray is a disaster. Chicken's overcooked, churros are embarrassing. What can I salvage? I love the china that you served the chivise on. Thank you.
I'm just kicking myself for letting Jeff take control of our dish. I know I'm a better cook than that. So I'm hoping the judges can see it's not representative of how much I've learned and how far I've come.
She's not gonna admit her mistakes because she cooks so great.
I don't have a problem admitting my
mistake.
I mean, it's honest. Tell the truth. I'm telling the truth. I think we did it together. And I don't think that I didn't do my part. I did my part.
Honestly, I'd never seen 2 individuals so distant from each other. There was no synergy, no harmony. But more importantly, you ignored each other. It was like 2 individuals that wouldn't set their egos aside to get each other over the line. And then this. Look at that. I don't know what to say. And what is this?
No chips and salsa.
Is it a magic trick? Shake the bag upside down. I'm sure it's gonna be a white rabbit. And what is that? I mean, seriously, I've seen more appetizing diapers.
I'm sure.
Would you just do me a little favor? Say a prayer before I tuck into this? Because I have to taste this now. Thank you for my 6 bag. Ah, disgusting. What's the positives? The chicken, it looks appetizing. And the churros actually taste quite nice. I see what you've both done in this competition, and you've had moments of brilliance. But tonight, you didn't listen to each other. And I think Jason has just hit a direct hit with both of you with 1 foot out the door. Good work, Jason.
I really feel bad that we did not work as well together as we should have. I think we allowed the pressure to get the best of us.
Do you stand behind what's in your box?
I am proud of 2 of the truffles.
Well, that's not good enough. Oh, no. No. Yashika, you may as well untie your apron. Looks terrible. What is that? Did you bite it?
It's horrible.
Jeez. These other 2 that you have completed need to be immaculate, let me tell you.
I dreamt up this dish, and it came out exactly the way I wanted it, so I'm hoping that the dream sequence continues to work out on my behalf.
Describe the dish, please.
It is a sweet and hot salmon with ancho chilies and chipotle with a braised Swiss chard, Tuscan white beans, and a citrus cream sauce.
Yashika, 40 minutes to nail this tonight. Twice the amount of time that Jeff had, and it looks disgusting. I expect someone to cook like that with 10 minutes.
I'm sorry, I really thought I was there with this one, but...
The salmon's hammered. It's not even dry, it's not even pink, it's hammered. I've served better fish than my cat. It's horrible. I'm sorry. How I can taste sour grapefruits with Tuscan beans with rainbow chard and a cream sauce and then sweet and sour blackened salmon, I swear to God. What upsets me, your flavor profile is unique. You cook like a dream sometimes, but you've just absolutely screwed that dish 100%. And you need to hope right now that someone behind you has a worse dish, because that is the worst dish I've seen at this stage in the competition in history. Thank you.
So
okay.
She goes. Check your head
this
out.
Dish was so awesome in my head. And now it looks like the dream that I had about the salmon dish is turning into a crazy nightmare.
The cook on the salmon is what?
Medium rare, but going more towards a rare. Exactly what I want.
Jeff, come on. Are you trying to poison me?
No.
Pear, cucumber, and apple, did you say?
That was cooked down and reduced within the stout beer, so that way then it kind of had that nice little bit of a sauce to it there.
It's weird. It's like sushi there. The fibers haven't even gone. Look.
But that's what I was going for. I wanted it to be on the rarer side.
Come on, young man. Are you saying you wanted it that rare?
Yes. Yes.
With rubber skin topped with feta cheese?
You know, I did go for a nice crispy skin.
Stout and cranberries and gratinated cucumber and raw salmon with feta cheese don't go, period.
Thank you.
I felt for you and given 20 minutes. Mm. But you're not going to lecture me that that's how you wanted to cook the salmon, because the salmon's raw, Jeff.
Thank you.